More bloodshed in Israel and Gaza. Thousands are dead, and now we know at least 200 are being held hostage. Good evening. I'm Amanda Hall.
And I'm Russ McCaskey. At least 30 Americans are dead. We News spoke to a man whose daughter is stuck in the war-torn city. He says he just wants his family home safely.
What about my American daughter and her five American kids? How do we get them out? That's my frustration. And darn right, I'm scared.
Wink News reporter Claire Gall continues her coverage of this family's fight to survive.
Twice, Emily Rauschenberger, her husband, and their five children made this harrowing drive from a shelter to the Gaza border with Egypt. Bombs going off. Smoke rising. I'm tempted to say rising in the distance. But when you see bombs going off and smoke rising, you're in a war zone. Twice. They made it to the border.
It's like a yo-yo. Go to the border, don't go to the border. Go to the border, you get there. It doesn't open up, nobody's processed.
Only to be turned away. Last Wednesday, John Rauschenberger came to Wink News, scared for his family. Told me no one in our government is listening to him. John said his daughter, Emily, an American, is trapped in Gaza with her husband and his five precious grandchildren. He made it clear they do not support Hamas. They were just visiting Emily's husband's family farm. We FaceTimed her.
There's lots of bombing, and we know there's nowhere to go. Here, you hear lots of booms in the distance, and you see lights in the sky.
After my story aired, Congressman Byron Donalds and Senator Marco Rubio both took John's story to the highest levels. His fear turned into hope. Saturday, the U.S. believed it had a deal with Egypt and Israel to get foreign nationals like Emily and her family out of Gaza. But they're still there.
The problem continues to be Egypt.
So what was supposed to be a family vacation is now a struggle to survive.
The food supplies are starting to dwindle. Bread is very hard. You know, the kids now haven't had any protein in a week. You know, there's no meat, there's no chicken, there's no fish, there's no dairy because there's no refrigeration.
John told me since the day we talked with his daughter, it's become increasingly difficult for him to keep in touch.
It rings in and drops. It rings in and drops. It rings in and I can hear her, she can't hear me.
But when they do connect, he checks in on the little ones.
The only thing that scares the bejeebies out of them are the rockets and the bombs.
And tries to keep their hopes up.
I got the kids on the phone when I got through yesterday, you know, first time in 36, 38 hours, and said, you know what? You guys make a list of everything you want. We're going to have an early Christmas. And she says they're arguing on what to put on the list.
Well, hopefully Emily and her family's plan is to try again at the border. They say they're going to try to do that tomorrow, but it is getting busier and busier. Israel warned Palestinians to evacuate south to the border, and now Emily says she's seeing hundreds more people a day.